yardstick, right? Like, how far away is that? And they brought it up real well in the play. Like, how do you know, like, when you're driving down a road at night, how do you know if it's not a bright light that's far away or a dim light that's really close? How do you know what that distance is, right? Well, this class of stars, these variables, and they're in the, you know, they're called Cepheids because that's basically where she found the constellation. She found a lot of these and really got that name. But they're all over the place. And it's a very specific type of star. And the connection with the, when she said, oh, I can hear it in the music, what that is that these stars, they pulsate. So they're small and then they actually grow big. I mean, diameter wise, they get bigger. And as they go in, and then they collapse back down on themselves and back and forth. So it's a harmonic oscillator. And it goes in and out and in and out. And so the luminosity, the light, amount of light coming out of it changes. And that, so you get a sine curve. So it goes high and then it goes to a minimum. And then the period at which it does that is very specific. And so she noticed that. She saw, wow, this one gets bright and then it gets dim. Right? Oh, and this one, oh, the brighter ones, they, you know, they actually go faster. And so she started to see what the periods were on this. And so she could use this as a yardstick because this is a class of stars that always do this. And she could make a connection between what your eye sees as the magnitude, you know, looking through the night, you know, because there's the atmosphere, you know, actually diminishes some of the starlight you see. So that's the apparent magnitude versus the actual magnitude of the star, the absolute magnitude. How do you connect those two? And she found a relationship between what you see with your eye and then the actual amount of light that really comes out of it. And from that relationship, you can actually determine what the distance is. There's a formula that he actually said it real fast. But all of a sudden, you have a yardstick because these type of stars, this classification always acts that way. Just like now, we tend to use supernovas because they always follow a certain life cycle. They always put out a certain amount of light. So when we see one, no, you have a yardstick, you know how to determine the distance. It's the light that's coming out of that object. Right, right. And so then that's how they knew,